such a way. We have to fix the price in such a way. Okay, so that is about allocation and mixture. This is about allocation and mixture. We are going to mix two different types of materials. Okay, it may be food material, something like that, and we will be selling it at a new price, and no profit, no loss, both for the seller as well as the customer. Now, this is the first problem in allocation and mixture. First problem in allocation and mixture. In what ratio must a grocer mix two varieties of pulses, 15 rupees and 20 rupees per kg respectively, 15 rupees, 20 rupees per kg respectively, so as to get a mixture worth 16 rupees 50 paisa. Okay, so he is going to mix two varieties of pulses, so variety A and variety B, two varieties of pulses. First one is rupees 15, second one is rupees 20. Rupees 15, rupees 20, and he is going to sell it at a new price. We are mixing both of this. Okay, pulse variety A, pulse variety B, and the new selling price is 16 rupees 50 paisa. Now, what they are asking, in what ratio they should be mixed, variety A, variety B, how many kilos they have to mixed, so that this new price will give no profit, no loss, both to the seller as well as the customer. Okay, so what we will do, you take directions in this fashion and subtract higher value minus lower value, follow the directions. In both the directions, find the question mark value. Find the question mark value, higher value minus lower value. Okay, so here 1650 minus 15 rupees, it is 1 rupee 50 paisa, 1 rupee 15 paisa. This side it is 20 minus 1650, 20 minus 1650, higher value minus lower value. This is 3 rupees 50 paisa. Now the ratio in which we have to mix pulse variety A divided by pulse variety B is 3.50 divided by 1.50, and it can be 3.5 by 1.5. If you multiply with 10, it is 35 by 15, it is 7 by 3. Okay, so 7 is to 3 is the ratio in which both the pulses should be mixed, so that if it is sold at a new price, 16 rupee 50 paisa, there is no profit, no loss for the both seller as well as customer. Okay, now I am going with the next question. In what ratio must wheat A at 10 rupee 50 paisa per kg mixed with wheat B at 12 rupee 30 paisa per kg, so that the mixture will be worth 11 rupee per kg? Okay, so they have given wheat A, which is rupees 10 rupee 50 paisa, and second variety is wheat B, and it is 12 rupee 30 paisa per kg. Same model, they are mixing it and going to sell it at a price of 11 rupees. In what ratio wheat A and wheat B, in what ratio they should be mixed? I asked you to put some diagram like this and follow the directions and find higher value minus lower value. Okay, so 12 rupee 30 paisa minus 11 rupees. 12 rupee 30 paisa minus 11 rupees. It is 1 rupee 30 paisa. This side 11 rupees minus 10 rupee 30 50 paisa is 050, 50 paisa. Okay, so 11 rupees minus 10 rupee 50 paisa, it is 50 paisa. Now, wheat A divided by wheat B, the ratio should be 1.30 by 0. It is 13 by 5. Okay, so 13 is to 5 is the ratio in which they should be mixed, so that the seller and the customer, both of them, will not have any profit, any loss. Okay, and it is just, it is a justice. Okay, though you mix it, you are selling it at a reasonable and correct price. Okay, no profit, no loss for both of them. Now I'm going to the next question. In what ratio must a shopkeeper mix peas and soya bean? Okay, same model, it is again same model. Only thing, whether they give wheat, sugar or anything. Okay, peas, soya bean. So same diagram we have to put. Peas and soya bean, rupees 16, rupees 25, and they are going to sell it at a new price, and the price is 19 rupees 50 paisa. Okay, in what ratio they should be mixed? Now 25 minus 1950 is nothing but 5 rupee 50 paisa. 1950 minus 16 rupees is nothing but 3 rupee 50 paisa. So the ratio in which peas by soya bean to be mixed is 5 rupee 50 paisa by 3 rupee 50 paisa. It is 55 by 35. If you cancel with 5, it is 11 by 7. So 11 is to 7 is the ratio in which they should be mixed. 11 is to 7 is the ratio in which they should be mixed. Okay. Now I'm going to the next problem. This is a new model. This is a new model. Here there is some gain percentage and all. I will come to this problem little later. Okay, because first we have to check on with the gain percentage, then we have to make the same diagram. In what ratio must a person mix three kinds of wheat costing him 1 rupee 20 paisa, 1 rupee 44 paisa, 1 rupee 74 paisa? Three wheats are there. Okay, three kinds of wheats are there. We will take it as A, B, C, three varieties of wheat. Okay. And the cost is per kg 1 rupee 20 paisa, 1 rupee 44, 1 rupee 74 paisa. So this may be 100 years back, not now. This may be 100 years back, not now. Okay. So that the mixture may be worth 1 rupee 41 paisa. Mixture may be worth 1 rupee 41 paisa. So first I will take A and B alone. First I will take A and B alone. A is 1 rupee 20 paisa. B is 1 rupee 44 paisa. Final rate is going to be 1 rupee 41 paisa. 1 rupee 41 paisa. They are mixing it, A and B. Now, higher value minus lower value in this direction 0.03. In this direction, it is 0.21. So, A and B should be in the ratio of 0.03 divided by 0.21, which is 3 by 21 or 1 by 7. Okay, this is mixing A and B. Now, I will take A and C. Now I will take A and C, do the same procedure. Rate of A is 1 rupee 20 paisa. Rate of C is 1 rupee 74 paisa. Okay. And the final rate is same, 1 rupee 41 paisa. It is going to be sold. 1 rupee 41 paisa. It is going to be sold. Now higher value minus lower value. This is going to be 0.33. And this side higher value minus lower value. It is 0.21. Now, A by C, in what ratio they should be mixed? 0.33 by 0.21. It is 33 by 21. And if you cancel with 3, it is 11 by 7. If you cancel with 3, it is 11 by 7. Okay. Now, if you see, this is equation 1. A is to B, we are taking equation 1. A is to C, we are taking equation 2. Okay. In equation 1, A value is 1. Equation C, equation 2, A value is 11. In equation 1, A value is 1. Equation 2, A value is 11. You should make them equal. You should make them equal. Multiply equation 1 with 11. Okay. Multiply equation 1 with 11. Okay. Multiply equation 1 with 11. What will happen? A by B will become 11 by 77. Okay. Now equation 2 is nothing but A by C is 11 by 7. In both the cases, A value is 11 itself. So if you write A is to B is to C, A is 11, B is 77, C is 7. 11 is to 77 is to 7. Okay. So this is the case when three different varieties are mixed and a final value is fixed up. Three varieties are mixed and a final value is fixed up. This is the procedure to do it.